Hi everyone, hope you are all healthy and safe. So today I will be discussing about the classification of cervical lymph nodes, that is the levels of cervical lymph nodes. There are many number of classifications which often make the students confused. So let's see how we can solve it. So let's start with why we need this classification. The first reason, as we know, different regions drain to different lymphatic regions or nodes. It also helps to describe the tumor progression pathways. Another important aspect is in standardization of procedures and reproducibility. That is, if someone says level 2A lymph node, it is just the same in your hospital or a center in any part of the world. Let's start with history. So here I am providing a timestamp. So if you want to skip the history, which I know might be boring for some, you may proceed directly to the classification part. So just check the timestamp. I included history only because I think it's relevant for you to know why there is so much confusion about this classification. Like why some textbooks say 6, some say 7, some give sublevels, some just don't mention the name of the classification. That is why I included history part. You may skip or stay. It is not academically relevant. So the first classification was made by Henri Rouvier in 1932. It was based on landmarks found during dissection, which is one big disadvantage and hence of not much use in clinics. Another popular classification of 1930s is MSKCC classification. In 1991, AAOHNS classified cervical lymph nodes into levels. This is also known as Robbins classification. So it divided cervical lymph nodes into level 1A, 1B, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In 1992, we have the TNM classification, which classified lymph nodes into 12 groups. In 1997, ACCC added level 7 to Robbins classification. Level 7 is nothing but the upper mediastinal lymph nodes. These upper mediastinal nodes, though not in neck, it can be involved in head and neck cancer, that is like subglottic, hypopharyngeal or thyroid malignancies. So 7 was added by AJCC. So even in 2018 AJCC, level 7 remains unchanged. In 2002, AAO revised the 1991 classification. They removed level 7 since they believed that level 6 included, that is 6 levels could include the whole anatomy of neck. And they divided level 2 into 2A and 2B and level 5 into 5A and 5B. These subdivisions were made because they thought there is some biological significance to these sublevels. First, we will see the AAO 2002 classification. We have level 1, then upper jugular, that is level 2, middle jugular, that is level 3, lower jugular, that is level 4, posterior triangle group, that is level 5, and anterior compartment group, that is level 6. 1, 2 and 5 are further subdivided. Each of them are further subdivided into A and B. So now let's look at each of them. So this is the reference picture. So I'll be showing only the levels and not the boundaries, which we will deal in another video. So this shaded portion is level 1. Here you could see that level 1 is further subdivided into A and B by the anterior belly of digastric. This is level 2, divided into 2A and 2B by spinal axis arena. That yellow line is the nerve. This is level 3. Now you can see level 4. This is level 5, which is divided into A and B by an arbitrary line passing through the lower border of cricoid cartilage. That purple line is the lower limit of the cricoid cartilage. Now we have level 6 also. So now the other relevant classification is AJCC 2018. It is just the same as AAO except for the addition of level 7 lymph nodes, that is the upper mediastinal lymph nodes. And also, there are some variations in the boundaries in AJCC compared to AAO, which we will discuss in the next video. Thank you for watching. And if you have any doubts, please let us know in the comment section below. Thank you.